It's a place on a trading platform in the city. It's a very contemporary piece. And I am the young gobby trader that sort of comes up from the old Barra boys that moved in the 90s. And so I've been there for 12 years. Not so much of a sophisticate, but the most successful and ambitious and aggressive trader of the team of five that we see in the play.
What was it about this production that excited you, that made you want to be a part of it?
I love the play. I thought the play was fantastic. I tried to be in it when they did it first time round. And yeah, so this was, they also serve those who stand and wait. This is a great production of this piece, and I'd like to think we've done it justice with this rendition of it. I wish this was the first time it was done, because we've done it really well. Everybody in the company's great. It's a really, really sharp piece. It couldn't be more relevant, and I'm really proud to be part of it.
Why do you think the city and that world continues to fascinate and appall us in equal measure so much?
What's interesting is that now people know a little bit more about it than they used to. You know, the libel case a couple of months ago sprung up while we started rehearsals. The way that that shares go and the way that banks are being bailed out. What's great about this piece is that it slightly explains as well as intrigues. So you come out of it with a bit more of an understanding about what shorting is, or how traders buy and sell, and how this invisible paper money market actually works. And you realise that people that do it are evil and lost in equal measures. So I'd like to think there's a bit of sympathy with the characters.
What does it mean for you to bring the production here, particularly to Finsbury Park?
No, I like the Park Theatre. I got offered a play here beginning of the year, and I was an absolute idiot. I turned it down. I've made up for it 9 months later. They asked me again, and I wasn't going to make the same mistake twice. I have a hidden agenda to get in with everybody here, because I think it's a great venue. It's full of possibilities, and it's a very robust team behind everything that goes on here, and I really want to be part of it moving forward. I'm three tube stops away. It's great. You do a bit of theatre and it sharpens you up. You get slim and trim, and you take all of that. It's very easy to be good in a film. There's a lot of people whose job it is to make you look and sound and, you know, and be good in it. There's none of that. It's bare and raw when you're on stage, especially a small venue like this. So you do this, it makes you a better actor, and then you'll take that to the next project that you do. You constantly need to be doing theatre. It keeps you sharp.
My name is Michael McKell, and I'm in Roaring Trade.
And Michael, can you tell us a little bit about your character and where he fits into the story overall?
I play a character called PJ, who has been a very successful man, but he's now at that point in his life where he wonders why he's chasing the pound. He's got the seven-bedroom house, the girls are at university, they've had a fantastic life, the holidays, the bonuses. And he's asking questions of himself. Why am I doing this now? And he's in meltdown. So he drinks a lot. Well, the great thing about when this play first came out about 7-8 years ago, we as a public didn't know as much about the banking world as we now know. And so it's now, we are an informed audience. So you get an insight to just what these guys are up to when they break rules. And they break rules for millions, and it can go literally in a heartbeat. Yeah, it's my second time working with Nick. I did a film with him called Death for Martin Gooch a couple of years ago. But it's a fantastic group of people. You've got Melanie and Les and Tim, the young boy in it. And also Will, who plays Nick's son. It's a great collective crew, and we have a brilliant director, Alan Cohen, who's pulled us all together. I love this place. It's got a great creative vibe, which sounds a bit, you know, a bit actory, but there's always people here. You meet rioters, and it's a fantastic environment. Obviously, there's the 90 as well, which is the smaller theatre, but it's a great place to come, and especially it's a studio theatre. It's like 220, 230 it holds. To a certain extent, you are not giving what a traditional theatrical performance, almost like TV and film, because they are so close to you. But because they literally see beads of sweat on your brow, there's no faking it. If a kid walks in here and sees a performance and think, I could do that, then it's important. And it's about being accessible. And this place is very accessible. They do lots of things with local schools. And so it's a very important venue, because there are careers out there that will be created because of this place. I mean, you'll find us online. It's the Park Theatre, Roaring Trade. We're here till the 24th of October. Come and see it. It's a great show.
Hi there, I'm Timothy George. I played Spoon in Roaring Trade. Much of the play is set on a bond trader's floor of a big bank in Canary Wharf. And Spoon is the new boy, basically. He comes in the third scene, fresh from the graduate office. He's a Cambridge grad, and he gets bullied quite a lot for the first half of the play, and then things start to develop. I won't give anything away too much. But yeah, he's basically the new boy who becomes quite a big deal on the bond floor. I think it's something to do with the fact that if you don't work in that environment, you actually know very little about it. And what you do know is twisted through the media and through news outlets. So there's a caginess around the city, which I think makes for good drama, because as soon as something is, you know, hushed up or sworn to secrecy, we just want to know more about it.
Can you talk about working with the rest of the cast, people like Nick Moran?
Yeah, they're fantastic. I mean, it's Nick's brilliant. It's lovely working with him. There's a little fight sequence that him and I are involved in, and he's been brilliant with that, because this is my first play where I've had to do any kind of stage combat, so that's been a bit of a learning curve. And they're a lovely cast, quite a diverse bunch. I think it's a very well-written play in that way, because you don't just have six of the same type. You've got very different characters, so the casting naturally brings together a mixed bunch of actors. It's fantastic. I love this theatre. It's my second time here. I did a show in the 90, which is the studio space. So to have done both spaces now is brilliant, and it's just a fantastic atmosphere. People, you know, have a real buzz about the park, and you can't put your finger on it, but it's a great place to work, definitely.
And if people want to come and see the production, where can they go for information about tickets, and when are you on till?
We're playing until the 24th of October, and you can ring the box office at the park. There's a number on their website, and you can book tickets through their website as well.
I'm Anne Pinnington, producer of Roaring Trade. It was very interesting because my grandson, who plays Spoon in it, brought the play to me and said, "Will you do this play?" And I thought, another play. I read it and I thought, it's fantastic, so I'll have to do it. And I was talking to the park about doing a play called Positive in the studio. And so I brought it to Jez at the park and said, "Would you read it?" He liked it. And so we did a deal to do both the plays here, because I love the park. I think it's fantastic. It's a great actor's theatre as well. The atmosphere is great. It's used all day, which a lot of theatres are not. And it's good for the community of this area as well, because they can come in and have coffees. And I just think it's a great place, and perfect for the two subjects that I've done here. I think it's timely now, because everyone knows a little bit about the city now. They didn't 6 years ago when it was written, but now they do. And that people are anxious to know more. They know it can be a little bit iffy, and I just think the whole point is that what it does to people doing that sort of job, it's a ruthless place. And I think people, when they go out, make them think. And even people who are working in the city, who I hope will come and see it, they'll think too.
I loved it. I think it's really different and really interesting. And I found myself waiting avidly wanting to know what happened next. That's always a really good sign. Yeah, it was fantastic. Yeah, really good. I thought the actors over the board were fantastic. Great use of the theatre. And, I mean, because it's one of those productions that turns over very quickly, I thought it was wonderful. It was so fast, the scene changes. It was almost like watching a film. It's really good, yeah. I think this place, the Park Theatre, is the place to be. It's really buzzy. The theatres are two theatres, one small one and one a bit bigger, are good sizes. There's a great bar, the food's great. Everybody's really helpful. There's fantastic rehearsal space. I hear from the actors that backstage is really fantastic. So I think it's the place to be. They're doing really good. Shows are starting to go into the West End and get a good reputation. So, yeah. Everybody wants to work here.
What do you think is the importance of live theatre, particularly for younger audiences?
I think it's really important to encourage young people to come to the theatre because although, I mean, and myself included, we all love TV and movies, but there's something really special about the theatre, that it's live, that it's happening there. There's a kind of pulse that happens in the building, in the whole building, and you can feel it tonight. It's very buzzy, very exciting. Everybody's got an adrenaline rush. There's nothing like it. So I think for any actor, you do a couple of years maybe of TV and film, but you need to come back here to kind of refresh yourself and get the blood coursing through those arteries again.
What are you working on yourself at the moment?
I'm doing lots of bits and pieces at the moment, which I'm really enjoying. I'm going to be really selective now, and unless something big comes along that I really... that really moves me and I'm desperate to do, then I'm going to keep doing bits and pieces till then, but I'm available.
Fantastic, yeah, here seeing Roaring Trade at the Park Theatre in Finsbury Park. First time I've been to the venue, firstly. I'm amazed, I'm blown away. It's a fantastic venue. They've got the theatre downstairs, another studio space upstairs. And secondly, yeah, the play is just is a great play. I've got a good friend of mine, Nick Moran, is in the show. He's fantastic in the show. And I would recommend you to get tickets. I think it's going to sell out. So, yeah, come and see Roaring Trade at the Park Theatre. It's good entertainment.
People who haven't seen it, can you just tell us about some of the themes and what interested you about that?
It's about a world I'm not very familiar with. So, yeah, it's about the all the traders in the city. I haven't got a clue what they do. And this play sort of outlines and gives you an idea of what those guys go through. And it's, added to that some high drama and great performances. So, yeah, great night out.
What's the importance, do you think, of live theatre, particularly, I guess, for younger audiences?
I think live theatre is a unique event, isn't it? It's you always have a great night out when you go to a theatre. It's just a good night. Just go.
You're a man of many talents. What are you working on at the moment yourself?
I'm taking a break from EastEnders at the moment, so I'm catching up with old friends. That's why I'm here, to see Nick Moran. I'm enjoying my time off and going out and seeing some shows again, so it's all good.
Why are you such a passionate advocate for this theatre?
Well, I was just thinking as I was watching the play this evening, I wish I lived just around the corner and could see every single play here. What an asset it is for the local people, but of course for London as a whole. And the track record of success that the Park Theatre has had has been absolutely astonishing. Of course, they need more money. They can't do all their own productions like this one. They have to be invited in, and that's all right for the audience, but for the health of the place, it just needs initially a little bit more cash. But it's always such a joy to come here, apart from the play. And Helen the dog, who you may not have seen this evening, is a wonderful hostess. So it's always a joy to come here.
What did you make specifically of tonight's production?
Well, it's a bit alarming because I live very near Canary Wharf and can see it out of my back window, and the projection and the very good set reminded me of home. I fortunately don't know much about what goes on inside Canary Wharf, so I can't judge whether it's accurate or not, but enough people who do know have assured me that things can get even more dramatic. Very entertaining indeed, and a bit worrying, as high finance always is to someone who's ignorant of it, as I am. Very, very, very lovely production and some really sparky acting. Very good.
Talking about live theatre, why are local theatre venues like this so vitally important?
Well, all theatre's important, but I mean, you can come and see a play here for a reasonable price. You know the standard of production is going to be high. you know there's going to be a good variety of plays on. You can get a reasonably priced drink and a snack beforehand. It's a good area of London. You're right by the Tube. It's part of life. It isn't just a special occasion. And although theatre can be that, I like the idea of theatre being as normal and everyday as walking through the park to work or going to the local swimming bath or library. You know, it's a local asset and helps define this area. Where do you live? Well, I live near the Park Theatre.
The theatre opened only 2 years ago, and since then we've had a number of West End transfers to the National Theatre, national tours, and next year a show going to New York. So it's been a really successful 2 years. As you can see, today the building is thriving, and that's how we like it here. This show, Roaring Trade, I hope is going to be a roaring success. Yeah, Roaring Trade was done once before a few years ago at the Soho Theatre, where it received great acclaim. But it's definitely in need of a revival, particularly with everything going on in the banking industry at the moment. It's in many ways more relevant today than it was. And in fact, the writers updated it, so it's a really fresh take on the story about banking and stock exchange. If you look at all the shows that have won the Oliviers over the years, look at last year, look at the shows playing in the West End, the shows that have even transferred to Broadway, they all start at small-scale theatres like this because there simply isn't the money around to be able to take the risk on huge West End venues. So it's really at the smaller off-West End houses where the excitement and the magic often happens.
The theatre has some fantastic, very familiar supporters, people like Benedict and Sir Ian. What does it mean for you to have that support from the acting community?
It's fantastic. It's incredible, and it's an incredible honour to have these supporters and friends. Ian's in tonight watching the show, and he's hosting a gala for us in November. Benedict hopefully will be there, filming schedule permitting. Emma Thompson, Gillian Anderson, Sean Mathias, Tamsin Althwaite, Tanya Moody, all our ambassadors, all our friends. It's really, really important, but it's vital for a theatre like us because we don't have any Arts Council subsidy, we don't have any government support. So the only way we can do it, keeping ticket prices affordable, is actually by a lot of fundraising. So it's a really important thing to have all of those people saying, you know what, we believe in Park Theatre, give them your support. It means the world. If you want more info, just go to the website parktheatre.co.uk. It's really easy to book. If you're local, we've got discounts. We have affordable ticket prices, so most of our tickets are under £20. We believe that theatre's for everyone and it's inclusive. So come on down, our doors are open, parktheatre.co.uk.